Well, the big advantage is that the listener, after having heard the piece so many times with the wrong instruments, suddenly hears a new piece. It's totally fresh. It's as fresh as it was at the first performance in 1803. And that is a shock. That's a surprise for modern listeners. I personally had a shock when I saw the Sixtine Chapel in Rome, Michelangelo, in restored, recent state. I couldn't believe my eyes. And first I was unpleasantly touched because I was so used to the faint colors and to the dust and to the, but now that it's cleaned, it's a shock again. It's fantastic. Mm. But you have to get used to it a little bit, that's true. You don't believe your eyes. And that's the same with hearing the Eroica in its clean state. You don't believe your ears in first instance. But soon you get used to it. Seldom more than one performance. There was no repeating. It was all first performances. So they did not get the chance to get used to a piece and to experience surprises not any longer as surprises. And it's clear that Haydn, Mozart and Beethoven, they took advantage of that situation. They had built in surprises in their symphonies, just to shock the audience, not to please them, like modern concerts are. And the public likes to be pleased. That's a modern attitude. Have a nice, beautiful, beautiful, quiet evening. And in Mozart's and Haydn's time, they wanted a frightful evening, full with genius of music. we have plans to enlarge and modernize the orchestra to do those the real 19th century. And the orchestra should be called then maybe Orchestra of the 18th and 19th Centuries.